Dearly beloved, we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God himself, signifying unto us the mystical union that is betwixt Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle that he wrought in Cana of Galilee, and is commended in holy writ to be honorable among all men, and therefore it is not by any to be enterprised, nor taken in hand unadvisedly, lightly, or wantonly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, in the fear of God, duly considering the causes for which matrimony was ordained. First, it was ordained for the increase of mankind according to the will of God, and the children might be brought up in the fear and nurture of the Lord and to the praise of his holy name. Secondly, it was ordained in order that the natural instincts and affections implanted by God should be hallowed and directed aright, that those who are called of God to this holy estate should continue therein in pureness of living. Thirdly, it was ordained for the mutual society, help, and comfort that the one ought to have of the other, both in prosperity and adversity, into which holy estate these two persons present come now to be joined. Therefore, if any man can show any just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. I require and charge you both, as ye will answer at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why ye may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, ye do now confess it. For be ye well assured that so many as are coupled together, otherwise than God's word doth allow, are not joined together by God, neither is their matrimony lawful. Benjamin, wilt thou have this woman to thy wedded wife, to live together according to God's law in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live? And namely, wilt thou have this man to thy wedded husband to live together according to God's law in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto him, so long as ye both shall live? Who giveth this woman to be married to this man? I, Benjamin, take thee, Naomi, to my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy law, and thereto I give thee my troth. I, Naomi, take thee, Benjamin, to my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us depart, according to God's holy law, and thereto I give thee my troth.
And I will always love you. My darling, you, bittersweet memories. That is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. Please don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need.